No matter how many times Biden or others in the government lie and claim that the Israeli government isn't targeting civilians, it's quite obvious that is what they're doing when they continually strike residential homes full of innocent people, strike churches, UN-run shelters, and just do indiscriminate bombings of Gaza citizens. Here we have an Israeli airstrike that hit two homes and killed 90 Palestinians. One person had 76 members of his family die.
Israel continues to resist international pressure to scale back its offense. On ABC's Jay O'Brien reports, Israel will continue to fire into Gaza until it has been totally destroyed.
The Israeli army releasing footage on Saturday, it says shows IDF troop operations around southern Gaza City's Isa district, the Gaza Strip, as well as airstrikes on some Hamas targets. Hamas rescue officials in Gaza claim an Israeli airstrike killed 76 members of an extended family, one day after the United Nations chief warned that nowhere in Gaza is safe. And that
Nowhere in Gaza is safe because no matter where people go, the Israeli government is going to bomb it. Even if they say there's a safe place to go to, they just bomb that new safe zone.
That the ongoing Israeli offensive is creating, quote, massive obstacles to delivering humanitarian aid. Israel striking various locations in northern Gaza on Saturday, including Jabalia, home to Gaza's largest refugee camp.
How is it not a war crime to be bombing a refugee camp?
UN estimates approximately 85% of Gaza's population has been displaced since the conflict began. A report from the UN and other agencies says a quarter of the population, or more than 500,000 people in Gaza, are starving. Prime Minister Benjamin.
So, a quarter of the population are going to die from starvation. How is that not a genocide?
Netanyahu continuing to emphasize Israel will not stop until it destroys Hamas and all remaining hostages taken on October 7th are released. On Saturday, President Biden spoke with the Prime Minister.
I mean, Netanyahu could easily destroy Hamas if the Israeli government stopped funding Hamas, because the Israeli government has been funding Hamas because they don't want the Palestinian Authority to be the sole government of the Palestinian people because they want a two-state solution.
Meanwhile, in the West Bank, the city of Bethlehem has canceled Christmas events, including festive lights, the tree in Manger Square, and activities for children.
The feeling in Bethlehem, we feel that we are in mourning. We feel very sad, as we are an essential part of Palestinian community.
City officials worry the cancellation of Christmas festivities, which typically draw thousands of visitors, will be a severe blow to the town's tourism-dependent economy. Jay O'Brien, ABC News.